Welcome to the Grokshop. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the ADB Android Debug Bridge. And the reason for that is I'm going to have some videos that use the ADB to help you get some things done on your phone, whether you're having problems or you just want to do something a little different, a little more power user mode. I'll put the link to this down below, but it's developer.android.com. So for those who might not know, the ADB is basically a way to talk to your phone through a command line interface, or CLI. You can use it over network or USB interface. I'll be using the USB interface in this video. So assuming you're not a developer with the SDK manager, click the download it here link to get the Android SDK platform tools download page open. Next, click the appropriate link for your platform. Now you just want to unzip the archive to your tools area. I use C:\tools in my case. I actually have an older version on here just to show how much changes there's been in about 6 months time. There's been some changes going on, so it's definitely worth getting the latest version. Okay, next we're going to want to get the USB driver for your specific device. Back at that same page, there's a link to install OEM USB drivers, original equipment manufacturer. And then there's a link. I'll put the link to this page, and then you click on OEM drivers, find your manufacturer and go to their page. So for example, if you have a Samsung Galaxy, you would go to the Samsung link there, end up at the Samsung site and click on mobile and phones in this case, and then Galaxy S, and then select your particular model. In this case, they want you to also select your carrier. Then you just click download and install the driver just like any other driver. In my case, I've already installed this driver, so it's saying, do you want to reinstall? I'm not going to do that here. Okay, next we want to fire up a terminal if you're on Mac or Linux, or command line if you're on Windows. You can type cmd and go to cmd.exe there at the top. Or for me, I have a command prompt that's already formatted a special way for me, so I'll go there. You can either add the folder you extracted to your path, or just navigate to that folder directly, which is what I'm going to do here. So if you just type ADB, you get the usage and whatnot. There's a lot of stuff in there we're not going to get into right now, but ADB space devices will show you if you have anything attached. You see right now there's nothing. So now you want to plug in your device, and on my Android 7 Samsung K Galaxy S6, this is what it currently looks like. Different Android versions and phones will have, sometimes you'll just get a notification. You got to go to the notification area, but you do want to allow USB debugging and you want to allow access to device data. Now, of course, you want to have developer mode turned on. I've got a video for that, so check that out if you don't have developer mode turned on. And then you should see with ADB devices, your device listed, and that means you'll be able to communicate with it. Okay, so just to illustrate a possible failure mode you might see in case you don't have one of these two options enabled. First, I will revoke USB debugging authorization. And interestingly, that doesn't take effect until the USB debugging is turned off and back on. So I'll go ahead and do that now. So first, just turning USB debugging off, you'll see it's back to not showing any devices at all. So now if you have USB debugging enabled, but you don't authorize the RSA key fingerprint, you'll see it's there, but it's unauthorized. So you do need to have both of those allowed. Okay, and then getting those back allowed again, we can proceed. Okay, so now if you type ADB shell, it'll actually open up a shell onto the device. So now you actually have a command prompt shell open on the device itself. And so example of one command you can do is top. And here I do top, the top 20 processes with top-m 20. And you can see, like, for example, if your phone's running very slow, what's causing it to run slow? The busiest processes are at the top. You can see 3% there used by my VNC. Nothing really heavy running on my phone at this point, but that's just one example of something you can do. Another example of something you can do would be direct file transfer. And you can see here opening up a file explorer on my phone. The path to the folders on the device aren't always so obvious, so I like to open this up and show you what the actual path would be to, for example, photos and movies from my camera taken recently. What I'm going to do is I'm going to grab everything from my camera folder and transfer it locally. And to do that, you do ADB pull. And then put the path from the phone and then your local path. So I'm just going to put it locally. So I'll put a dot, which means put it locally. So after 48 seconds, it looks like I pulled about 1.3 gigabytes and averaging 26.1 megabytes per second. So that's a wrap for your ADB intro. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for some more interesting applications of the ADB interface. That's how it's done.